an amazing feat at such a young age, at only 21 years old. Combination. And look at that, Kolova using the long pimples, which means that the more you topspin the ball into the pimples, a defensive player, you've got more time on your hands, but there's different spins to deal with. And it looks like Noskova won 4-2 against the Italian stallion Debra Vivarelli. So we've got Noskova in Mikhailova's corner now, so they've both helped each other out. Imagine if they'd have to play each other. So much experience against Chop before. Goodness me. Oh, she does so well to recover the net. Oh, that's better. That's a lot better. Rather than relying on the chopper to miss, which doesn't usually happen. Yeah. Now than she did at the start. Maybe it's just taking her some time to get used to it. National Championships. He won it in, I think, 2000 and then 2009. And Mikhailova looks like she's been one of them at the moment. As a defensive player, you're looking, I've got to attack, but strong, because if I don't, the defender that I'm playing against can turn defence into attack. Sort of ball coming at her could cause her a few problems. She'll want to adjust to that quite quickly. The level's so similar, but because whoever's more confident and believes in himself more. Then just close the gap. I'm not sure whether that clipped the edge or not. I can't tell what her body language is sort of meaning. I swear she got the brute force to past this wall of defence. Oh, well, it was the best rally. That's devastating, isn't it? 2-0, 22. Shows the solidness of their defence. And it looks magnified players, they're always looking to improve. And that's called a kind of sport that has such fine margins like table tennis. The first chop they do tends to be float, tends to be no spin. So that's your chance to win the point early. Make use of the first floaty chop. She just can't put the ball to where Mikhailova's bat is. That's nice. About 75%. She can rely on that forehand. But the more experienced Mikhailova is just... It's Polina with the serve though. Oh, it was... The previous game, it's the young player that has a game point. Can she take it this time though? This time she can! ...that you'll get if you have a chopper and attacker that are similar levels to each other. often why you can learn a lot more from losses than you can from actually winning a match. Ooh. Dribbled over the net. And the morale of Mikhailova doesn't look to be going up. It definitely looks like those backhand pimples are coming into use. She's using it as a push and a lift. Mima Ito. Rather than spin up. Yeah. 6-4 to the 21-year-old. As I expected, I think it's because the contrast in styles is just massive. I doubt very much that these two train against players like they're playing against now. Kazuo Hashimoto, Lin Yunju, who in my opinion is the breakthrough star of the year, winning the T2 League, the Oman Open as well. But the T2 was the standout. He beat Fan Zhendong and Ma Long. Oh, and that's exactly what she does there. Beautifully spread. All of a sudden, you had Sathyan, Gnawa Kasaran, Anthony Almaraj, the youngster. She could be on the verge of doing great things for Indian women's table tennis. She lost in the semi-final of under 20. And she beat Ida Zabcek of Croatia 4-0. 11-5, 11-2, 11-8, 11-5. In the last round of quarter-finals. In a position where she can take a few risks now. She's got a cushioned lead. Oh, look at that backhand. He's one of Europe's brightest hopes, as well as Truls Morrigard, Christian Platea, Rara Sipos, who was playing here. Beautiful chops there with the forehand. He'll play slightly more patiently. But she goes for the forehand and it pays dividends. Good point away now from getting into the finals. Well, it's beautiful variation. She raises her hand in celebration. And it's going to be an all-Russian affair in the women's singles final because Polina Mikhailova